Okay, so what I was telling you that it's possible that we can push one carbon below and one carbon above. In that way, you will have that more of the hydrogen will be kept in the torsional in the gauge form, because by just pushing only one, we will be able to bring about only four hydrogen in the gauge form. But if you are putting two in the one above and one below, by that way you will be able to, you know, put more hydrogen in the gauge form. That will give even more stability to the structure of the cyclopropane. So that is called band shape. I don't think that they have given it here. You can search that band shape. You can also try that on through the model. So band shape, what will be the idea? The idea would be, the plan would be to keep one carbon above, one below. So two of the carbon will be out of the plane, out of the five carbon, rest of the three carbon, they will lie in one plane. By doing so, you will have, you know, the angle that is substandard between the two carbon will be around 108 point something, 0.5 around. So it means that it is 1 degree or something, 1 degree less than the ideal angle 109.5. So it means that the cyclopentane structure is nearly equal to the ideal angle, right? So that's why cyclopentane structure is more stable, but could be even more stable when we put two of the carbon out of the plane in the band form. So are they twisted? You can say that. So the angle is 108.5, that is only 1 degree deviating from the, which is, we can see that almost equal to the ideal angle. So angle, there is a less degree of angle strain in the cyclopentane, but there is a high degree of the torsional and the steric strain. Because of certain, comparatively less than the cyclobutane, but still there's a space, further space for the stabilization by doing something more, and that will be possible just by pushing two carbon out of the plane. So this was the Newman projection for that, and this is the 3D structure of the cyclopentane. And this is the envelope shape, and they have not drawn the band or the twisted form, so you can do that by yourself. Now coming towards the cyclohexane, right? Cyclohexane among the cyclic structure, starting from the cyclopropane, we see that as we are increasing the carbon in a ring, the rings are becoming more and more stable. The cyclopropane was less stable, cyclobutane more stable, cyclopentane even more stable. And now cyclohexane is the most stable structure. But this ascending order is again reversing as you are moving ahead of cyclohexane. I mean, if you are moving from cyclohexane to the cycloheptane or the cyclooctane on it. In that case, the stability will again be reversed. The order of stability will be reversed because of the certain carbon, they are coming in plane again, right? But in the most stable structure, as I said, is the cyclohexane structure. This structure is considered to have the zero ring strain. Why? Because every carbon of the cyclohexane is considered to be sp3 hybridized, and even it is sp3 hybridized with an angle of exactly 109.5, which is the ideal angle, right? But this is not always the case in the okay. So what about the torsional strain and the angle strain? If we talk about the most stable conformation of the cyclohexane, that is the chair conformation. In chair conformation, all these strains have been overcome by the ring just by pushing more carbon out of the plane. Just by pushing more carbon out of the plane, the ring has attained the lowest energy conformation, so called the chair conformation. Because in chair conformation, the amazing and the most beautiful thing is that every hydrogen is staggered, or gauche anti to the every other hydrogen in the neighbor. Right? For instance, this is gauche anti to this one, this one to this one, this one to this one. Overall, there is no steric strain. And even there is no torsional strain. There is no angle strain. We have already talked about that, but because the angle is 109.5 degree, which is perfectly aligned to the ideal angle 109.5, exactly equal to that. No angle strain, no torsional strain, right? And because all the siege bonds, they are staggered, and there is no steric strain as well. So cyclohexane exists most of the time in its more stable conformation, that is called the chair conformation. It is this one. But the other conformation of the cyclohexane could be, that is possible, is the board conformation or the twisted conformation and half chair conformation. So what you can do, just I can tell you the most easiest way just by analyzing that, right? During the on-campus class, I can also discuss about these thing, and we can make a practice of on this. Just look at here. This is the Newman projection of the chair conformation. So how we are looking at this, just for instance, let's suppose you are looking from this side. Okay, you are looking from this end. What you will see? You will see this whole carbon and this whole carbon. Right? So I have drawn two of the carbon, that is one and the other. So I have drawn, starting from the center, I have drawn the hydrogens everywhere. Is it this one? Is it this one? But this one is connected to the other carbon, because you can see here, hydrogen, hydrogen, the other one, the center one is connected to this carbon, right? So you can see that this way. But the back carbon, what about the back carbon? This will be hidden, this will be hidden, this will be hidden, this will be hidden. So you can see that they are hidden, the back carbon. We can only see the front carbon, right? So there is, on the back side, there's one carbon. On this back side, there's one carbon. So if I'm looking at here, one of the carbon, right? One of the carbon will be hidden at one side and the other will be on the other side. You can see when you are looking at this position, right? You are looking at this carbon and at this carbon. In this way, you can see that this is going below. One of the ring, this is going below, the other is going above. One is going above and the other is going below. So the above one, you can see here, this is CH2. And here, this is the below one. Right? And now, what has happened, this back carbon, this will be hidden. One of the back carbon will be hidden. In this case, it is this one that is going below, because you are looking at this side. This one is below, and on the other carbon, this one is above. And this carbon is being hidden by this one. This carbon has been hidden by this one. These center two, they are the ones which is going above and below. So this one is going up, it is this one. This one is going below, which is this one. And this is the behind one, two behind one. This has been hidden by this one. And this has been hidden by this one. Now, this is the overall structure. This is called the chair conformation. Now, the question is that if I am, let's suppose, pushing it here, how to do that? So just push it down this way. You can push that downward. So first of all, what would be happen? It will be more like this way. Then it will be completely straight one. It will be the next. Then it can come this way. And then again it can come this way. So chair, half chair, twist it. Again, boat, half chair, and then full chair. So this is the overall sequence. You can make a practice on this. Just by pushing it down, you can get various sort of the confirmation. Just make a practice on this. Right? So slightly you can bring it into the, now it is chair, then you can know, see that twisted, half chair, again full, you can bring it and down again. So in this way you can come up again to the chair confirmation. So it is a very good practice, just pushing it down. I think now it's very easy for you to draw the Newman projection as well as to make a practice on this. So you can also draw the energy stabilization diagram for this, where you are showing the energy, the angle of rotations versus the potential energy. So the most so you can tell that the most highly unstable structure would be half chair, then would be twisted boat, then the chair conformation is the most stable one, right? So in this way you can make a practice on this, and then I can show you that below. See, this is the most, I can give you the overall summary, then you can see there, this is the cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, and then cyclohexane. You can see the stability order of all these structures. But the what about the chair conformation? In the chair conformation, you see that the bond, they are becoming more axial and equatorial, right? So out of the six hydrogen, you see that three hydrogen, they are axial, and the other three, they are equatorial, and most importantly, they are staggered to each other. So six hydrogen will be vertical overall, and in the other part, the six hydrogen, they will be at vertical, and the other six will be at the horizontal. So six axial hydrogen vertical to the plane of the ring, and six hydrogen equatorial to the plane of the ring. But what I'm interested in, most importantly, that every neighboring hydrogen to the every other hydrogen in the neighbor, is they are staggered to each other, right? So this is the detail you can study about all these things here. So this is the overall step, how to draw the chair conformation. I think this is an easy job. You will be able to do that. You can draw the structure. These are very basic things. So I'm not wasting time on these things. Let me explain in the other video.